Okay, so today we are going to revise. Now am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so today we are going to revise momentum and the three laws of motion. Clear? So earlier in this topic we have already revised about force, balance and unbalanced force. Today we are going to revise number one, momentum number two, laws of motion. There is some problem. Just listen to me, okay? Laws of motion, there are three laws of motion. First, laws of motion. Second, laws of motion. And the third law of motion. Now, who can tell me what is momentum? What do we understand by momentum? Yes. One by one. I will listen to everyone just one by one. What do you understand by momentum of a body?
Momentum of a body is the product of its mass and velocity.
Okay, very good. And anyone else?
Momentum is a vector quantity.
Very good. Very good. Yes. Momentum is denoted by small p and which is equals to m into v. The SI unit is equals to what? Kg meter per second. Further, momentum is actually giving you the product of mass and velocity of a body. Yes? Yes, please. Go ahead. Batao beta.
Momentum is the product of mass of a particle and its velocity.
And ma'am, also the rate of change of the momentum of the body is directly proportional to the applied force and its place in the direction in which force acts.
Good. So, aapne second law of motion ko use karke bhi momentum ko define kar diya. Very good. Now, who can tell me what is the first law of motion? First law of motion. Yes, one by one. Yes, sabko chance milega one by one. Yes. Now tell me, on board with beta.
Kashish.
Okay, go Kashish. Just tell me what is the first law of motion. What does the first law of motion states? And what is the other name of the first law of motion?
Ma'am, may I tell?
Yes,
what?
Yeah. Very good. Now, can anybody give me one example for first law of motion?
May I give you?
Yes, Pragati.
Yes, ma'am, I'll give you. Ma'am, example is a book is lying on the table and it is not pressed. So, the book will not move by itself unless and until we apply an external force to it to make it to in motion. Like,
yes.
It
good. Very good. Now, what do you understand by second law of motion? Yes.
The second law of motion states that the rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the applied external unbalanced force.
Good. And how will you show it by the numerical terms? Kaise aapko kahoge? Okay, good. Chalo. So from second law of motion, what we get? We get that second law of motion simply represents force equals
force.
Yes, okay, you can just give.
Newton, the riding of bicycle is a good example.
example of this law of motion at work. When you push on the pedal, your bicycle accelerates.
Okay, good. So force equals to mass into acceleration is the second law of motion. Further, force is directly proportional to rate of change of momentum with time. So this is our second law of motion. Secondly, third law of motion. What does the third law of motion represent? Yes, one by one.
Yes.
Just go ahead.
Ma'am, may I?
Yes.
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, one by one.
Ma'am, can you tell the first law of motion formula?
Yeah?
There is no formula, it's a statement only, the first one.
The first equation of motion and those equations of motion you have to derive from graphical method. मैंने आप लोगों को होमवर्क दिया था कि आपको तीनों ग्राफिकल वो डेरिवेशन मुझे भेजने हैं. आई नीड टू टू थ्री स्टूडेंट्स हैव सेंट मी इवन द यस. अच्छा फिलहाल आप बताइए थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन क्या होता है. यस फटाफट बताइए. Yes. ये भी क्वेश्चन आता है.
Now
just explain me the third law of motion.
Yes, ma'am. Third law of motion is that every action is a result of motion.
Okay. Now note down this question.
Ma'am, I am stating the third law. The
yes.
Third law states that every action in nature, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Which means like we have object A, but we exert a force on object B. Then the object B will also exert equal and opposite force on
Yes. Now do this question. Now do this question. Yes. The one who is speaking. Yes. Speak. Yes. Who is speaking?
Yes, ma'am, I'm speaking. Ma'am, according to you, third law of motion, ma'am, whenever one body exerts force on different body, or we can say another body,
yes.
The second body would definitely exert equal and opposite force on the first body.
Okay. Like, now, Ayush, you speak. Ayush, it's your turn now. You speak.
Yes, ma'am.
Just you speak.
Ma'am, when you jump, your legs apply force to the ground.
Yes.
The ground applies an equal opposite reaction force that throws you into the air into the flat third law.
Very good, very good. Anyone else want to speak? Vartika, you are raising your hand. Vartika, you want to speak?
Yes,
go ahead, Vartika.
Yes. Ma'am, the third law of motion states that to every action there is an equal and opposite reaction.
Yes.
And they act on two different bodies.
Okay.
For example, when we hit a ball,
yeah,
we apply a force on it. And okay, in return, the ball will also apply an equal force on us.
Now, okay, very good. Now, Aditya, Srini, Swasti and Lagnatika, all those who are raising your hand, just tell me the answer of this numerical. Just solve this numerical and answer me this. Okay? I am giving you 1 minute. This is a 1 minute question. You will do it very fast. So, in this question, what is given? What is the acceleration produced by a force of 12 Newton exerted on an object of mass 3 kg? So in this question, what is given? Force is given. Force is about what? 12 Newton. Again, mass of the body is 3 kg. And you have to to find out the acceleration produced. So, which law you will use over here? कौन सा law आप use करोगे? Very good. Now you know that the formula of the second law is mass into acceleration. Okay. Now just tell you, just raise your hand. You got the answer.
My hand.
Okay. Lagna Jitha, you will answer now. Your hand, Shivam, Lagna Jitha. Those who are listening, get a bit of one by one. Everyone should get that chance. Okay. So first of all, yes, Shivam, do you want to answer the question? Lagna Jitha, yes, speak beta. Lagna Jitha, what's your answer?
Man, four.
Four what? What is your unit? Yes. 4 meter per second square. Good. How many of you got the answer 4? कितने लोगों का answer 4 आया है?
Ma'am, I have got.
Okay. So most of you got. Yes. Now who is speaking? Prabhat is speaking. Yes, Prabhat. Tell me the answer. क्या answer आया बेटा? फटाफट बताइए. 4. आगे आपको unit भी लिखनी होती है. So the answer acceleration comes out to be 4 meter per second square. Clear? आपको कितने लोगों को मैथ जिनको नहीं आया है जस्ट सी F equals to ma. यहाँ से आप a equals to क्या लिख सकते हो? Force upon mass. Force आपको कितना दिया हुआ है? 12 newton. And what is the mass of the body?
Question is not equal.
3 for the 12.
Yes. Clear? Now note down the next question. A bullet of mass 4 gram of mass 4 gram when fired with a velocity when fired a bullet of mass 4 gram when fired with a velocity of 50 meter per second can enter a wall up to a depth of 10 cm. Just wait. Yes. Now listen to me very carefully. The question is a bullet of mass 4 gram when fired with a velocity of 50 meter per second can enter a wall up to a depth of 10 cm. How much will be the average resistance offered by the wall? तो पहली बात तो यहाँ पे आपको equation of motion लगानी पड़ेगी और equation of motion से आपको acceleration find करना होगा. And after finding the acceleration, you have to find.
Please don't tell.
Okay, just try. Just try it out. I'm giving you 1 minute. Just try the question. Yes, calculate. I'm giving you 2 minutes. After that, I'll just start solving it.
Yeah.
okay, just tell me the answer फटाफट से. तब तक मैं साइड से थोड़ा सा सॉल्व करना शुरू करूं. Okay, so you can see from this question, first of all you will write what are the things that are given. तो आप क्वेश्चन में देख सकते हो आपको सबसे पहले दिया हुआ है मास ऑफ द बुलेट विच इज 4 ग्राम. नाउ यू नो दैट आपको सारी चीजें ऐसा ही यूनिट में लिखनी होती हैं. सो यू विल राइट दिस 4 ग्राम मास इनटू व्हाट केजी. आपको इस पर लिखना होगा मास इक्वल्स टू 4 ग्राम दिया हुआ है. व्हेन यू चेंज इट विद किलोग्राम यू विल डिवाइड इट बाय 1000 विल बिकम 4 × 10⁻³ kg. So this is the mass of the bullet in kg. Now initial velocity is given. U is given 50 m/s.
Your voice isn't audible.
Beta, you can see the board because the mic is on the right side. I told you so many times when I was using board, my voice will not come to you, you know, clearly. So just note down the things that I am writing on the board and then listen to me when I was on mic. Clear? The next thing which is given is U equals to 50 m/s. V आपको दिया है 0.
मैम का आंसर इज कम.
आपको फाइंड आउट करना है A.
Yes.
S आपको दिया है 10 cm. यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट इनटू मीटर एंड दैट बिकम्स 10/100 m एंड दैट इज इक्वल टू 1/10 m. दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ S. So first of all, you will find out what? You will find out acceleration, and for that you will use which equation? You will use equation v² - u² = 2as. Now what is v? V is 0. S की वैल्यू कितनी थी? 50 m/s² × 2 × a की वैल्यू 1/10 × s. So sorry, this is the value of s. इसकी वैल्यू एस की वैल्यू एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट ए. सो फ्रॉम हियर यू विल गेट व्हाट ए की वैल्यू कितनी आएगी. कितने लोगों ने निकाला? हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए?
मैम फोर्स हैज कम इन सेल.
फोर्स कितना आया?
मैम
दिस इज 50 न्यूटन. वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. सो यू आर करेक्ट, ऑल ऑफ यू आर करेक्ट. Yes, very good. So this is -2500, which is equals to 2 × 1/10 × a. Or when you come, or आप इसको solve करोगे तो a की value कितनी आ जाएगी? A will come out to be 1 − 1250 - 1250 m/s². So when you get got the a, you will use. So this is the first part. तो आपने acceleration find out कर लिया. Now you have to find out force. तो F equals to कितना होता है? Mass into acceleration. तो आपको निकालना है actually the resistance offered का मतलब है जो force opposite direction में लगाया है body ने. So what is the value of mass? Mass is given 4 × 10⁻³ × −1250. And when you solve it, it comes out to be −50 N. This is the value of force. When you solve,
-50 N.
Yes, very good. And minus sign tells you, this minus sign tells you that the force or direction of force is opposite to the motion. जो भी motion हो रहा था उसके opposite direction में this force is applying. Clear?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, we can also say that the bullet was applying 50 N because the according to third law of motion.
No, actually आप गलत जा रहे हैं. हाँ ये हो सकता है इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट फोर्स लगा रहे हैं, बट आपको मैंने बताया था ना बैलेंस एंड अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्स के बारे में, तो डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज, हो सकता है इट्स ओवरऑल फोर्स, समझ लो जो एक्स्ट्रा डिफरेंस ऑफ फोर्स बच रहा है मे बी दिस इज दैट फोर्स. चलो ठीक है नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दिस क्वेश्चन इज होमवर्क फॉर यू. नोट डाउन a bullet of 10 gram strikes a sandbag. A bullet of 10 gram strikes a sandbag at a speed of 10 to the power 3 meter per second. At a speed of 10 to the power 3 meter per second and gets embedded E-M-B-E-D-D-E-D, embedded after traveling 5 centimeter. क्वेश्चन का मतलब ये है एक बुलेट है जो कि 10 ग्राम मास की है और वो सैंड बैग का मतलब जिसमें यू नो सैंड होती है उस वाली बॉडी के अंदर आप क्या करते हो उसको फायर करते हो फायर कर बुलेट तो वो बुलेट 10 टू द पावर 3 मीटर पर सेकंड की स्पीड से जाकर उस बोरे में जाती है एंड अब आफ्टर ट्रैवलिंग 5 सेंटीमीटर इट गेट एम्बेडेड टू इट तो वो क्या होती है स्टक हो जाती है आफ्टर ट्रैवलिंग हाउ मच डिस्टेंस 5 सेंटीमीटर. नाउ यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट नंबर 1 the resistance, the resistive force exerted by the sand on the bullet. Clear? So first part mein you have to calculate the resistive force exerted by the sand on the bullet and number 2 you have to calculate the time taken by the bullet, the time taken by the bullet to come to rest, to come to rest. Clear? Have you note down the question?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this ma'am. आप लोग इसका आंसर मैं आपको आंसर बता दूं या फिर आपको मैं आंसर WhatsApp क्लास के टाइम बताऊंगी?
Yes, ma'am.
Please repeat once.
Okay, I'm just repeating. Or you can just you can just hear to the video. The question is there only. ठीक है? तो आप लोग वीडियो को पॉज करके क्वेश्चन सुन सकते हो. Note down the next question. Down the next question. A force of 5 newton produces an acceleration. A force of 5 newton produces an acceleration of 8 meter per second square on a mass m1 on a mass small m1 and an acceleration of
could you please mind from because of network problem it's not audible.
See, I'm speaking it is clear in the video. जब आप video देखोगे तो आपको question को साफ सुनाई देगा क्योंकि if I'm writing to it will take more time. So I'll just what?
Please continue.
I have not got your voice clearly.
Now please continue after that acceleration
of. Yes, and an acceleration of 24 meter per second square. On a mass m2. Full stop. What acceleration would the same force provide if both the masses are tied together? Clear? So these two are your homework. You have to do these two questions. You can send me your answers and then I'll send you the correct solution on the WhatsApp time. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Chalo, so till then, please do revise all the topics, all the whole chapter, all question answer, reasons and numericals given in NCERT. And these extra numericals I am giving you, you have to do that also. Clear, but be prepared NCERT first. पहले एनसीईआरटी के सारे जितने स्पेशली इंडेक्स क्वेश्चन एंड क्वेश्चन आंसर्स यू हैव टू लर्न और रिवाइज वेरी क्लियरली. ठीक है बेटा, दो चैप्टर मोशन एंड फोर्स एंड लॉज ऑफ मोशन, दीज आर द टू मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर्स. सो स्पेंड योर मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम ऑन दीज टू चैप्टर्स. क्लियर? चलो गिव मी टू ऑल द व्हाट्सएप क्लास टाइमिंग. क्लियर?
Thank you, Mom.
Bye.